Very different underlying meaning. So, language learning is not only about exploring other people's ideas and ways of living, it can also be a great trip of self-exploration. This, of course, depends very much on the frame we have been looking through since birth, and those, of course, are the cultural and the social programs we grow up with and we are used to. Anyway, learning a language therefore means so much more than just learning words. It's actually basically about learning how to understand each other, and often this is a great struggle for meaning. So, the most important lesson is probably the realization that we cannot possibly assume that other people will see, and that means understand, the world in the same way that we do. Although we are ever so often tempted to do exactly this. And this actually points to the very limits, not only of our everyday communication, but also, of course, politics, and also maybe to science. So, but in other words, looking to the Turkish frame for us and my family and me, we didn't really see the Turkish world, of course, and it wasn't the Turkish culture, but a great variety of different things. Anyway, let me explain with a seemingly simple example what I mean. Now, all over the world, people drink tea, right? In Germany as well as in Turkey. But, having a closer look, we see that in Turkey, drinking a tea very often means something like getting together, being social, or having a chat, maybe in sight of a problem, grabbing a tea and discussing what to do. In Germany, people also drink tea, but it's got more something like the idea of staying healthy and fit, and people in Germany, maybe a little also in opposition to drinking coffee, which is more regarded as a sin. But in Germany, no one would dream of grabbing a drink inside of a problem. Germans would get on, they grab a manual, they get the problem solved, and afterwards they would regard or consider having a drink. But this could probably more often would be a beer, and maybe not so often a tea. Anyway. With the realization that we are also different looking at the world, and after we have actually been here the first couple of days in Istanbul, we realized that also the Turkish grammar was just brilliant. It was a zone almost without exceptions. You all know it, that because you learn German, and I know this, German grammar is such a nightmare because of all these exceptions. Turkish grammar has such beautiful features like no articles, they are German. No prepositions, they have no capitalized nouns here in this language. And what is so great a discovery for teenagers, there's a special tense for gossip. This is so wonderful. And plus, the words are always pronounced the way they are spoken. Just imagine English spelling, English pronunciation. They seem to be the furthest away planets in the universe. Now, in Turkish, it's actually dead simple. You may not always trust the taxi drivers here, but you can always trust the spellers, and this is fantastic. Plus, they're extremely entertaining. All the words that have traveled into Turkish, French, German, and also English words, they are so funny to read for us. So, just imagine the football vocabulary, half of it is based on English words. And just like shoot, like goal, out, offside, penalty, for instance. And here are actually my all-time favorite Turkish delights. Cheesy and go and find someone who gets the tips of my hair trimmed, which means Können Sie mir bitte die Haare schneiden lassen, aber so, dass man es anschließend nicht sieht? Here in Turkey, you can choose a hairdresser. And those hairdressers sometimes even promise not only a haircut, with the haircut, something like a personality transplant. No, look, our local hairdresser has called his shop Metamorphosis. And this is actually what I meant with the phrase. It's going back to this. Maybe this refers to the Turkish way of spicing up everyday life with a tiny little bit of fiction. And this is so wonderful. Whereas in Germany, most Germans love to be authentic, they love to be real and true as possible. Which is fine too, but ever since we set foot on Turkish soil, we are actually delighted about all those little surprises, our observations, and are also about these really sometimes funny encounters. They actually also make us constantly reframe ourselves, and this means growth. Now I would like to actually move to my step. To the school in Hanover. And the school in Hanover, they did something really outrageous. They introduced a German-Turkish bilingual program. And I say it again, a German-Turkish bilingual program, not a German-English program, like all the other schools in the world. Thousands in Germany, thousands in Europe, and elsewhere in the world, they used Turkish for education. Now, why? And also, the most important thing, I think here I can already say it, is it's a program for awesome German-speaking kids. It's not just for the Turkish-speaking kids. Now, why would something like this be so outrageous? You probably all know that in Germany, about 3 million people speak Turkish. Turkish is a language in Germany alive and kicking. You hear it everywhere in the big cities across the country. You can see it, you can read it. It is really a lively language. So, but unlike languages like, for instance, Japanese, Chinese, Russian, Polish, Danish, and all the other European national languages, Turkish is not a foreign language subject at German schools. So, Turkish probably has such a bad image in Germany. It's still the language of the poor immigrants. And there are so many prejudices about it. For instance, some people think it's an unlearnable language, it is not. Some deny it's exotic, and those are prejudices. But the fact is that when we re-migrate to Germany one day, our children will not be able to continue learning Turkish in a foreign language subject. There are foreign languages, there are Turkish classes, but usually those kids visit those classes who speak Turkish at home. Our kids would actually not be able to speak them. Now, with a school in Hanover, something similar happened. It is a neighborhood with predominantly Turkish-speaking families. A lot of families found cheap housing in this area, and it is a working class family. None of the German middle class families wanted to send their kids to that school. So it was actually the school for the Turks. A horrible reputation, actually. So, but now, 10 years later, this school is one of the best schools in Germany. Eine deutsche Schule ist eine der besten Schulen. And they came actually 15th among the last final 15 schools in the Deutsche Schulpreis, which is something like the educational Oscar in Germany. And that means they have really done well. But what happened? How did they achieve this? Now, I told you that I have introduced this program, German-Turkish program. And it was actually initiated by the few remaining German families who said, couldn't our children also learn Turkish as a foreign language? And a brave school management said, yes, we try this. And then they implemented it, and they especially wanted to attract the middle-class families. Now, what's happening at the school? is the following. German speaking and Turkish speaking and children with other languages too meet in those bilingual classes and they start learning Turkish in grade 1. They have 5 lessons per week in Turkish, and it's also important to realize not just language lessons, they use it just like you use German, they use it for math, they use it for science, for arts, and for music, for instance. Alright? And English only is taught in year 3, which is great, it's normal, it's easy. English is something like a Germanic dialect. It's so easy to learn for Germans. But Turkish is hard. Anyway, this is how they actually improved their English. And I have now been investigating this school. My research question has been the following. What happens if an otherwise very much stigmatized language, immigrant language, is used for educational purposes and by some doing upgraded? That was my research question, and here are a couple of my findings. Now the first really important finding is the school still operates under very hard conditions. So most of the families, or many, many families, are poor. There are many one-parent families. Many families are still once migrated to Germany, but now there is a much better mixture. They also have academic families, and they have the German middle class families back at the school. They are actually queuing up to get in. Right. Now, this is one of my findings. The middle class family came back, and there is a much better mixture. But now let's ask, why would actually this program be good for any bright German middle class kid? Why would it be good? Now, and here is my findings. Actually, the first graders, they experience Turkish as being something really normal, it belongs to the school. They will never criticize or never question it. But they realize, wow, this is so much, so interesting. So because Turkish is a very hard language to learn for Germans, it will mobilize a lot of cognitive powers. They need to really put more effort into this, which is great for their overall development, of course. Also, it is a very, very unusual language learning experience. Just imagine German and English being so similar, but German and Turkish being so different. This will contribute to their language learning awareness, and those will lay the foundations for lifelong language learning. And you know how important languages are for business, for trade, for international relations. You all have this idea in your minds. And so it will contribute to that too. Now, because they always are actually taught together, the German kids, and the Turkish kids as well, they realize how hard it is to learn a difficult language like Turkish, and this means they understand that learning German is just as difficult for other kids. Like you, I'm sure you sometimes suffer from your German lessons as well, but it means that they have respect for each other, and they value each other. Then, point 4, equality grows as well. Because they would actually not look down on other kids anymore who have not yet learned perfect German, because they are in the process of learning it, just like they are in the process of learning Turkish. This will break the color difference that you often find in schools. With that, also, some of the clever pupils, they actually learn Turkish in the morning, then they go home in the afternoon and they realize, wow, this is a language I can use in my neighborhood. So they realize it and they start using the language they learned at school. Not just like me, I had to wait 10 years like that until I could actually then use it. And so they will get a lot of positive feedback. This will overall really contribute to their cognitive community skills. Turkish will also provide them with access to the multilingual reality in the country in which they live and grow up. So many Germans, of course, haven't got this access, but they can go and they can exchange little phrases with the greengrocers and in the shops. And of course, this is also very valuable, so the connection to reality problem. Now, altogether, these kids have such a positive attitude towards Turkish. It is just brilliant. They are brilliant ambassadors for this language because they carry this attitude into their families and also into the society. Now, then let's have a look at why would this program be good for the Turkish-speaking kids. Now, the Turkish-speaking kids, first of all, they realize, wow, the other kids, they take an interest in my culture, in my language, and this is really something valuable, that you value, and of course, proud. So, it goes without saying that they grow in self-confidence. But, because they also learn, most of these kids are actually born in Germany. They're all, most of them have also German passports, but they are brought up with Turkish at home, but they do not really know much about the country and the history of the language they use. So they will learn in this school also something like content knowledge about their roots, their ancestors, and this will make their identity grow as well. As I said before, Turkish is also used for science and math. Science and math are hard and tricky subjects. We have heard this also earlier, high up on the agenda of every school. Perceived to be difficult, but with Turkish, they have an easier access to those hard subjects. Plus, they will also extend their vocabulary. So their vocabulary will also grow. Altogether, because they experience themselves as advanced learners in the language classes, these kids would then also have a more overall, they help each other, and especially also the kids that are learning, starting to learn German, they get help. That means their overall attitude towards learning and school gets improved. They have not this idea, I'm always lagging behind, I have no chance to catch up, because I know I'm good at this and they are good at that. And this is something also very important. Because they are together in the class, and because now there are German-speaking role models in the classes, and they build friendships, and they meet each other outside school, they would also more easily, more naturally grow into German. This is why the school is such a success. They need, we need the great mixture. And that makes their German vocabulary also grow. After all, and that is something that the school can clearly provide evidence for, is that after 4 years at that school, these kids actually go home with much better academic achievements. So overall, their options and also their schools' success will grow. That's why, altogether, this school has not only opened space with that program, they have opened space for intercultural learning, intercultural encounters. They meet each other on the same level, treat each other as equal. But they also contribute to more social and educational justice. Now, languages are used, often used, or maybe sometimes also misused, as political weapons. We all know this. But in times of globalization and also intense mobility, languages have actually ceased to be national symbols. Now, media and powerful internet technology open up windows actually to all languages, to all cultures in the world. And with the help of shareware, with the help also of communication platforms, you can start learning a new language tomorrow without the help of a language teacher, actually. So we all know languages are so useful and so important for success in life. That's maybe also might be one of the reasons why I chose this school, you learn German. But after all, we shouldn't forget, languages also provide us with new frames, exciting new frames of looking at the world from a different angle. Now, minority and immigrant languages, just like Turkish in Germany, but also, for instance, Punjabi in Great Britain or Kurdish in Turkey, our languages are such frames. They are actually the hidden sources, the hidden treasures in our societies, and I think we should start taking notice of their great value for mutual understanding, intercultural learning, but also something like education, social justice. And as such, not only the individuals here, the kids at this school in Hanover, they will grow, also the society will grow as a whole. And now I will use my final sentence. It's also one of my family's most favorite ones. In times of global times, we should not forget that not airports connect people, languages do. Thank you very much.